Anyway, mga kaparya, sa video nating ito tatalakayin natin ang mga stock balita update na ating nakalap para sa ating PSE Stock Market Philippines. Ngayon ay December 5, 2021. Saka dito pala guys sa ating Kabarya Avenue PH YouTube channel, sinishare natin yung ating experience at dinodocument yung ating pag-aaral sa mga nakita nating pangmasang Pinoy investment at potential digital assets in investment na pwede tayong kumita kagaya ng stock market, Pag-ibig MP2 Savings and Investment Program, GCash Investment, Cryptocurrencies and Altcoins gaya ng Bitcoin, Cardano, Dogecoin, Binance, Litecoin, Chainlink and Ethereum at iba pang pangmasang Pinoy investment. Kaya guys, kung trip at korsonada mo ng ganitong mga content, pwede mo ring pindutin yung red subscribe button dyan sa baba para ma-update ka pa ng ating mga latest na ina-upload na video tungkol sa ating pag-aaral ng mga pangmasang Pinoy investment at potential digital assets in investment naman. Alright, bago natin umpisahan guys, huwag nyo palang kalimutang basahin yung disclaimer na nasa screen ng ating video. Okay guys, ladies and gentlemen, sa videong ito tatalakayin natin ang mga PSE stock balita update na ating nakalap ngayong December 5, 2021. At reminders lang po na hindi po ito financial advice, hindi rin po ito recommendation to buy, sell or hold any stock or any digital investment. Ito po ay for your information update and for education purposes only. Kaya kung ready na kayo, let's jump in. Alright, unahin nating i-discuss ang PSE Stock Balita Update ng ating PSEI from Philippine Stock Exchange para sa ating mga investing public and trading participants. Subject: Adjustments in Trading Hours. Date: November 22, 2021. Please be advised that effective Monday, December 6, 2021, the Philippine Stock Exchange Incorporated will go back to its pre-pandemic full day 5-hour trading schedule. Bukas na ang magiging implementation nito guys, Monday, December 6, 2021, ang ating PSE market trading hours: 9 a.m. pre-open, 9:30 a.m. market open, 12 noon market recess, 1 p.m. market resumption, 2:45 p.m. pre-close, 2:50 p.m. run-off trading at last, and 3 p.m. market close. Okay, next is stock balita update natin from PhilStar Global dated December 2, 2021. PSE suffers a massive drop back below 7,000 level. Basahin natin. The struggle to retain that 7 is real. The trading yesterday wasn't panic exactly, but the mood was definitely red from the start and only got redder as the day went on. As one commenter put it, the PSE started down but not down. And that was true, but stock just kept losing steadily throughout the day and closed down over 3.5% right the near season lows. If you do a research on Google, you'll see Omicron fears in all of the headlines, but there's something else lurking behind all of this: the US Federal Reserve. The US is concerned about inflation and has signaled that it may be interesting to raise rates sooner than anticipated to combat the risk of prolonged higher than optimal inflation. Isa sa dahilan kung bakit pabagsak ulit ang ating market ay dahil sa lumalabas na bagong variant ng COVID-19 virus, ang new virus variant na Omicron. Kaya doble ingat ulit tayo, ugaliin nating gumamit ng face mask, maghugas ng alcohol, and keep 1 meter distance in public. At dahil mahirap magkasakit, ingatan din natin ang ating sarili at ang ating mga pamilya. with regards to Omicron virus variant, ang sabi ng isang analyst, mag-struggle pa ang ating PSE market hanggat hindi natatapos ang pandemic period. Omicron may delay Philippine economic recovery to pre-pandemic level up to year 2023. Okay, i-play natin itong video update from ABS-CBN dated December 1, 2021. Philippine shares plunge 3.5% to 6,900 as Omicron fears linger. I-play natin. 1, 2, 3.
Major Asian markets bounced back on Wednesday on calmer nerves as investors assess the new COVID-19 Omicron variant. Oil prices also jumping 2% in Asian trading hours. But it's a different story here in the Philippines, which is playing catch-up to Tuesday's losses when it was on break. The panic selling continued, with the index plunging 254 points or 3.5% to close at 69.47, its lowest in nearly 2 months. The drop is also the sharpest since August 13.
For now, we attribute it really to, as you said, it's panic selling. A week ago, everyone was really bullish. In fact, you know, people are saying, well, they were looking at their projections and they're getting ahead of themselves, seeing as to when we're going to hit 8,000, which they're saying probably in, you know, by the first half of 2022. Now, probably they're going to be changing their estimates. But I think we're calling it too soon again.
East-West Bank's Angel Pasi sees the market consolidating over the next 2 weeks as investors await more data about the new variant and the efficacy of the current vaccines.
If you mean by Santa Claus rally, some relief rallies towards the end of the month, yes, I think he's still going to pass by for a brief visit. Now, that being said, are we going to be significantly higher from where we are at now? I think it's going to be a toss coin event in the sense, toss coin event because we don't really know what we're going to find out about the new variant. I know that a lot of bad news is being factored in now without any data just yet. I think what the market is waiting for is really some assurance.
Among the day's most actively sold down stocks, AC Energy down 4.6%, BDO by 4.8%, and Ayala Land by 3.8%. In corporate stories, Megaworld set to develop a 5 billion peso central business and boutique hotel district in its 462-hectare township in Palawan, the Paragua coast town. The company expects to generate some 5 billion in sales from the master-planned Mercato Shophouse District and the Porto Hotel District, both located inside tourism enterprise zones, which means they will enjoy tax holidays. Big picture, Megaworld has allocated 40 billion pesos to develop the entire ecotourism township over the next 10 to 15 years. Meanwhile, Yuchenko-led construction firm EEI Corporation targets to nearly double its workforce, vowing to hire 10,000 workers next year. It says the construction industry is flexing its muscles as COVID-19 restrictions are relaxed, and EEI will take advantage of this development and will go full blast next year. EEI currently has a little over 13,000 employees across different projects worldwide. And finally, DMCI's Barong Nickel in Palawan is setting aside 110 million pesos for the decommissioning and rehabilitation of its mine site in Quezon over a 6-year period. This will cover 109 hectares of surface mine, 209 hectares of silt control structures, and 25 hectares of stockpile area. The mine site opened back in 2006 and will be fully depleted by the end of this year. It yielded some 10.3 million wet metric tons of nickel ore and 2.6 billion pesos worth of mining duties, royalties, and taxes. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.
Sunod nating stock balita from PhilStar Global dated December 1, 2021. Solar Philippines Nueva Ecija Corporation, PSE SA, offer period starts today. The offer period for Solar Philippines Nueva Ecija Corporation, SPNEC, 1 pesos per share sa kanyang IPO, institutional and broker tranche started back on November 25, but the offer period for the PSE SA tranche starts today and runs until December 7, 2021. Para sa mga gustong humabol sa IPO or yung tinatawag na initial public offering, ni Solar Philippines Nueva Ecija Corporation, SPNEC, hanggang Tuesday po ito, December 7, 2021, through or by PSE SA IPO subscription. Okay? Solar Philippines Nueva Ecija Corporation, from Call Financial, IPO announcement. Nagsimula na ang IPO nito sa ating PSE o yung tinatawag na Initial Public Offering. Ang magiging stock code ni Solar Philippines Nueva Ecija Corporation ay SPNEC. Ang presyo ng kanyang IPO ay nasa 1 pesos per share. Ang minimum subscription nito, 10,000 shares. Kaya ang total minimum nito, 1 pesos times 10,000 shares is equivalent to 10,000 pesos ang minimum subscription nito. At para sa mga korsonadang kumuha ng IPO ni SPNEC, mayroon tayong dalawang option na pwedeng pagpilian. Ang IPO offering period ng ating option 1, LSI Local Small Investors through PSE SA from December 1 up to December 7, 2021. Ang IPO offering period naman ng ating option 2, Call Financial Online Subscription. Nagsimula na ito, November 25 up to December 6, 2021. At ang PSE listing date ng ating Solar Philippines Nueva Ecija Corporation, SPNEC, ay sa December 17, 2021. Inuulit po natin, nagsimula na po ang IPO ni Solar Philippines Nueva Ecija Corporation, SPNEC. Okay? Next stock balita update natin from PhilStar Global, dated December 2, 2021. SunTrust Home Developers owner arrested by Macau Police for running a cross-border gambling and money laundering syndicate. Bad news ito para sa ating stock na si Sun. Okay, sunod nating stock balita update from Business World, dated ito ng December 3, 2021. EEI gets PSE nod for 6 billion pesos FOO follow-on offering. Basahin natin. The Philippine Stock Exchange PSE has approved EEI Corporation's application for its 6 billion pesos follow-on offering. The exchange approved the application of EEI Corporation for the listing of up to 60 million preferred shares, subject to the follow-on public offering of the company at an offer price of 100 pesos per offer share, the PSE said in a listing notice on Thursday. EEI's offering comprises 40 million preferred shares with an oversubscription option of up to 20 million preferred shares. The company plans to issue the shares as Series A preferred shares and or Series B preferred shares. Net proceeds from the offer will be used to partially fund EEI's future projects, to pay for its existing short-term loans as budget for new equipment and for general and working capital requirements. EEI aims to conduct its offer period from December 9 up to December 15, while the listing of preferred shares is slated for December 23. Shares will be listed under the ticker symbol EEIPA and EEIPB. The exchange's approval of the listing of the EEIPA and EEIPB shares is subject to the company's compliance with all the conditions and post-approval requirements of the exchange, the PSE said. The company tapped RCBC Capital Corporation as the sole issue manager of the offer, and it will be joined by SB Capital Corporation as joint lead underwriters and bookrunners. Ang offering ni EEI ng kanyang FOO o yung tinatawag na follow-on offering, ito ay preferred shares offering. Dalawa ang magiging preferred shares offer nito, Series A at Series B, under the ticker symbol EEIPA and EEIPB. Okay, next stock balita update natin from Business World, dated ito ng December 5, 2021. Artaland raises 3 billion pesos from shares offering. Real Estate Developer Artalan Corporation raised 3 billion pesos from its Series D preferred share offering. According to the Philippine Stock Exchange Incorporated, PSE said in a statement on Friday, Artalan will use the funds raised from the follow-on offering to redeem the Series B preferred shares, LCPB, issued by the listed developer in 2016, the PSE added. Proceeds from the LCPB share sale was utilized by Artalan for acquisition and development of real estate projects, repayment of loans, and general corporate purposes, it said. PSE President and Chief Executive Officer Ramon S. Monzon said the follow-on offering of Artalan was more than 1.5 times oversubscribed, signifying the warm reception by investors. This comes as no surprise as more and more investors integrated sustainability into their investing criteria, Mr. Monzon said. Although nasa pandemic period pa tayo, marami pa ring interested investors ang nagbubudega sa kanilang investment portfolio. In this period of pandemic, marami na tayong na-encounter na stocks ang nag-offer ng IPO, FOO at SRO, and most of them are granted dahil interested ang ating mga domestic and foreign investors. Most of our long-term investors ay nagbubudega ngayong mababa pa ang ating PSE index because they anticipate that after this pandemic, most of the stock player will goes up, lalo na yung mga blue chips and all have potential stock in the market. At ang panghuling stock balita update na ating nakalap from Philstar Global, dated December 5, 2021. Aboitiz Power to start construction of solar farm in Pangasinan. Manila, Philippines Aboitiz Power Corporation is eyeing to start construction of its latest solar farm in Pangasinan this month. The company would soon issue the go-ahead to its contractor to build the 74 megawatt AC or 94 megawatt DC solar power facility in Bugalyon, Pangasinan. Aboitiz Power President and CEO Emmanuel Rubio said during the virtual energy investment forum hosted by the Department of Energy on Friday. For our 94 megawatt DC solar project in Kayanga, Bugalyon, Pangasinan, the engineering, procurement and construction EPC tendering process is in the final stages and the target notice to proceed is expected in the first week of December, he said. Rubio said the project is expected to be commercially operational by the fourth quarter of year 2022. Maganda ito dahil dumadami na ang nag-a-adapt sa technology ng ating renewable energies at malaki ang maitutulong nito sa improvement ng ating environment. Okay, bago tayo matapos, alamin muna natin ang kaganapan sa ating PSE market. From ABS-CBN News, dated December 4, 2021, PSEI ends lower for third straight week. I-play natin at panoorin itong PSE video update from ABS-CBN. The PSE index ends lower for a third straight week even after clawing back some of its recent losses on Friday. Michelle Ong reports. I-play natin. 1, 2, 3.
Philippine stocks led most emerging Asian markets higher on Friday as panic over the COVID-19 Omicron variant eased, while regional currencies were more subdued following more hawkish remarks from U.S. central bankers. For the day, the PSE index added a third of 1% to close at 70.55, advancers beating decliners 2-1. Although it still posted its third weekly decline. AIA Philippines' Mike Bengson reminding investors the Omicron news flow is an unfolding event and they're keeping their 7,800 target for next year.
Before the variant news came out, we were looking at a target for the PSEI of 7,800 for next year. At this point, we haven't changed that, but much depends on the hard data on this variant. with regard to transmissibility, how much our vaccines protect against it. I think in the short term, I think the market is in for a consolidation phase until these questions are answered. Trade within a range, I think between a range of 7,000 to 7,200. But again, I think one should not be too fixated on year end, right? That's like less than 30 days from now. One must simply just keep updated on what's going on with Omicron. And, you know, if it turns out that, you know, it is actually less deadly and our vaccines protect against it, then the market may actually start moving higher again next year.
In corporate stories, Globe Telecom signs a 10 billion peso term loan facility with BDO and another 5 billion facility with Land Bank to finance CapEx and refinance debt. As of end September, Globe has already invested a record 65.4 billion pesos, already exceeding 2020's full-year investment of 60 billion, mostly to boost data networks. Meanwhile, Metro Pacific Investments President and CEO Jose Maria Lim is retiring by the end of the year and will be replaced by Manny Pangilinan, who will now be Chairman and President effective January 1, 2022. Lim has been with the group for 26 years. MPIC is a holding company with interest in infrastructure through Metro Pacific Tollways and utilities through Meralco and Maynilad. Looking ahead, starting on Monday, December 6, the PSC will be back to its pre-COVID operating hours and trading will run from 9:30 to 3 p.m. with a one-hour break from 12 to 1. Yet another signal, corporate Philippines is ready to go back to business as usual. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.
All right. At yan ang ating mga nakalap na PSE Stock Balita Update ngayong December 5, 2021. Magkita ulit tayo sa ating kasunod na video. Once again, have a happy weekend Sunday. Always stay safe and God bless. Hanggang sa muli.